Hello everyone, in this video we will learn how to estimate a model for panel data with a generalized method of moments or GMM estimator. For this purpose we will use the PLM package. The command is pgmm estimate a model using GMM for static or dynamic model. We start first by downloading the PLM package. You can follow my steps. First go to the packages, after that install and write PLM. After that just click in install. For me I already installed the package, so no need to reinstall it. The second package is read Excel. Because of my data is stored as an Excel file, so I need to download this package. For air to just open this data. So as you see, here is my data. I have four variables, period from 2004 and 2015. The first variable is Gini, the second is GDP, it's a regional GDP, the third one is the capital, and the index. As you see, my third variable capital is unbalanced variable. As you see, this is my region, it's 12 Moroccan region. So we'll run this command to load data to R. The second step is to define data as a panel data. As you see, here is my data. Regional, that's my data. As you see, when I run the command view regional, it show me my data. It means that the R is already stored my data and you can use it. Here is my data. Four variables, 12 regions. Moving now to the PGMM. As you see in the command, the description of the model to estimate is provided with a multi-part formula. As you see, we have three parts. The first part is the formula. In the command, you see that GDP equals log GDP 1 plus log GDP 1 plus the difference of the index 1 plus the difference of the capital. Here is the formula. It's the first part. In the second part, or in the second part which is mandatory, describe the GMM instrument. I choose that the log of the GDP from the second period to the 12 as an instrument variable. For the third part, which is optional, describes the normal instrument by default, all the variables of the model which are not used as a GMM instrument are used as a normal instrument with the same log structure as the one specified in the model. So here is the third part, or the third partition. The variable that I didn't use as an instrument must put here. For more detail on this concept of a multi-part formula, So I have the first part of the formula is a symbolic description of the model. In my example, I have the GDP or the dependent variable explained by lag dependent variable plus the Gini lagged variable plus the difference of the variable index plus difference of the variable capital. As you see, the second part of the formula, which is important to indicate it, describe the GMM instrument. As you see, I choose from T plus 1 to T, which is indicate the period. In my example, I have 12 year as an instrument, and indicate that all lags from 2 of the GDP or the dependent variable used as a GMM instrument. The third part of the formula, which is optional, it means that doesn't matter if you add it or not, describe the normal instrument by default. All the variables of model which are not used as a GMM instrument are used as normal instruments with the same lag structure as the one specified in the model. We finish this multi-part explanation of the formula by indicating that these two codes are the same. Doesn't matter if you add the third part of the formula or not. I should mention that the choice of the number of lagged or the variable that should be instrumented, it depends on your data and the empirical work that you want to do. And the baseline theory that we work on. In the code, I have the data equal regional. The data that I have already mentioned in the second command. Choose between two effects. The first one is individual. Or two ways. These two concepts we should explain. These two concepts. the canonical form of the model, as you see in this picture, here the individual effect is alpha I and the theta t is the time effect. It is a two-way model if both are present. Those alpha I captures effects that are specific to some panel unit but constant over time, whereas the theta t captures effects that are specific to some time period but constant over panel unit. So whether you need both, it depends on your research question. For example, if I have a panel of firms, theta t might represent business cycle effect, whereas alpha I would contain firm specific effects that can be argued to be constant over time, such as the culture or the firm. Here the two ways, here means both individual and time effect. So if you include two ways, it means that you include the individual and the time effect in the same time. So it is just two specifications. Two forms. The first one is one step, the second one is two steps. It depends on your research paper or research problem. Option, if it's true, that means that the GMM instrument are collapsed. if it part is a transformation, we have two options, option D and option LD. So the kind of transformation to apply to the model, either D, the default value for the difference GMM model, or LD for the system GMM. Transformation indicates how the model should be transformed for the estimation. D gives the difference GMM model. We have the reference, you can see arrow line and bound. The LD, the system GMM model, you can see blindel and bound 19, 19, 18. Estimator, as you see here in this image, the matrix of the one-step estimator can be I, it means identity matrix, or G, where the D is the first difference operator if the transformation is D. Or the GI or full if the transformation is LD, if LD is the system GMM and D is the difference GMM. So this this line, it depends on the previous line, is the transformation D or LD. Moving now to estimate our model. to run the code, just clicking Control plus Enter. Here is the result. We will not interpret the model because it's just an artificial or synthetic data. As you see, here is my coefficients. So this the PLM package give you the possibility to update the result when you change, for example, the effect from individual to to two ways, or when you change the model from two steps to one steps. As you see in the model, now I will change model two ways. We have already explained the difference between individual and two ways. The model also, can you change from two steps to one step? It depends on your problematic or your empirical baseline. As you see, the first model called test 01, and the second model is test 02. The difference between these two models is just the effect and the model. It's the same data, the same formula, and the same variables, the same period. The difference only the effect and the model. As you see, here is the result of the second model called test 02. I use the one way effect two steps. As you see, here is the formula GDP equal the dependent, the lag dependent variable GDP, the second variable is the GNA and the difference index, and the last variable is the capital. Here is the instrumental variables. I choose to collapse the GMM instruments. For transformation, I used system GMM. I have a balanced panel, 12 cross section and 12 year. The total is 144. The number of observation 204. It means that this 204 included the GMM instruments. Here is we have the residual. For the coefficient, we have the coefficient of the lag dependent variable. It's highly significant. We have here three stars, significance code. For the test of the Sarge test, here is the p-value. The test of the autocorrelation for the first order, and the test of autocorrelation for the second order. Here is the wild test for coefficients. I will not interpret the model because it's just a synthetic data, it doesn't mean anything. The simulation is just to show you how to use this the package PLM, or how to estimate a GMM method. Some codes that can help you to if you want a deeply interpret your model. For example, if you want the vector of the coefficient, just write coefficient and the name of your model. For example, I have model test 02. Here is the vector of your coefficients. For me, I have three variable and dependent lag dependent variable. The second one is the residual. If you want the vector of the residual, just type residuals and the name of your model. Here is the vector of the residual for all the periods. The third one is the covariance matrix of the coefficients, phi cov, and the name of your model. Here is it's a covariance matrix. The last command is the vector of the fitted values and the name of your model. Here is the fitted. So the time dummies, the dummy variables, you need just to type time dummies equal through that you can include the time dummies in your model. So when you estimate the model, you have the time dummies for all your period. For example, I have from 2004 to 2050. So if you mention here through, it means that the model will estimate, and you add the time dummies to your estimation. So thanks for watching. For the data and the code that I used is down in the description. So see you next time.